This video shows how to compare multiple event frames with each other in PI Coresight. We assume a viewer already knows how to find event frames and apply event frame time ranges to PI Coresight displays. Here I'm looking at is a display for an event. This is for the blender uptime, which is part of my paint making process. The process variables that I'm looking at for my blender are the agitation, pH, and pressure. And all these process variables for the blender uptime are specific to blender 400, which you can see here. I want to know if this agitation cycle is similar for other type of blenders at my plant. In order to do this, I will need to investigate the blender uptime for blender 400 with another type of blender, say my blender 500. Now, to find event frames for Blender 500, I'm going to need to add data items to my Coresight display that are for Blender 500. In order to do this, I'm going to need to go back to the search here, and I'll just add some process variables for Blender 500. You can see that I'm looking at Blender 500 here, and I'm going to add some of these process parameters. I'm going to add the agitation, pH, and pressure so I can plot what I was looking at for Blender 400 in another trend. Now I have information on Blender 500 alongside Blender 400. The problem is I still can't make a one-to-one comparison because I'm essentially just looking at the same time frame for both of them. This time frame doesn't necessarily correspond to when each of them went through an uptime process, because that could be different between different blender. In order to make a one-to-one comparison, I'm going to need to compare event frames. In order to do that, I'm going to go back to my Related Assets and Events tab down here. So it looks like I have several events in my event list. How can I tell which ones are specific to Blender 400 versus Blender 500? In order to identify that, I'm going to take a look at an event by drilling down, clicking on the arrow. If I look under Assets, I can see which asset that it's for. This one, the first one, is for Blender 500. Let's take a look at the second one as well. Again, clicking on the arrow, scrolling down, and looking at the asset. Okay. This one is for Blender 400, so I can look at each of these uptime events for the different blenders. What I'll do is I will select the time range for the event. This one was for Blender 400, so I select time range and drag it into my Blender 400 trend until I see the green plus sign. Afterwards, I can confirm this by taking a look at the time range of my Blender 400 uptime. Okay, perfect. This is matching 9:29 and then 10:39 as well. Another thing you'll notice is that the trend is also now locked to that particular time frame. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing for the event frame that was for the Blender 500 here. Select time range, drag it to my display. Again, my time ranges match at 9:29. And 10:21 here. My trend has been locked. And now I'm making a comparison specifically for the blender uptime, which you'll notice I have different actual start and end times, but I can compare like things. One thing that I'm noticing right away is that there are two peaks in agitation, but they look like they occur at different times depending on the blender. In addition to comparing trends, I want to look at some additional information to continue to make my comparison. First, I want to know, well, were we making the same product in both of these uptimes? And what was the average agitation? This type of information I wouldn't really put in a trend because it's just going to be a single value. Data items that were captured for an event frame can easily be added. Let me show you how to do that. First, I'm going to focus on Blender 500, so let me just remove Blender 400 from here. I want to add data items for the same uptime event. So I will go to this same uptime event in my event list, and I'll select it. And then I will drag it into this blank space above the trend in my display until I see this green plus sign. Then I can add values. The reason why I've chosen to add them as values instead of a table is that the event frame attributes in Coresight tables will show the raw values of the attribute at the end time. If I expand over here in my event list, you can see that the data items that I'm looking at are things like the minimum, the maximum, and average. And these are things that I don't want to have the raw value at the end time, but actually what the min, max, average were for that event frame. In order to have them represented accurately this way, I'll need to add them as values. So you can see here I have the minimum temperature, the maximum temperature, the average agitation, and information regarding the type of paint I was making. This is all information for this uptime for Blender 500. I want to compare this to Blender 400. Remember in PI Coresight, there's only one display time frame, and the trend can be locked, but things like values and tables can't. An easy way to make a comparison is to just open another browser window. So I've done that here, and I want to do the same thing for Blender 400, and that way I can do a comparison. So I have Blender 400, and I'm going to, again, select the Blender 400 uptime event, drag it into the white space, and add them as values. Okay, and let me just resize this so we can take a look. Okay, perfect. I can tell that for Blender 400 and Blender 500, both times I was making green paint, and the agitation average RPM was a little bit higher with Blender 500 versus when it was at 44 RPM for Blender 400. Also, I can easily pick out that my maximum temperature for Blender 500 was about double what it was the maximum temperature for Blender 400.